Hey, this is Chris, and I'm going to be talking about the new Tetris, which was an N64 game that came out in 1999, so it's not such a new game anymore, but to this day it remains one of my favorite versions of Tetris ever. So here you go.
We all know what Tetris is, so what's the deal with all the hammering and manual labor in the opening cutscene? More on that in a minute, but where the actual game of Tetris is concerned, all the basics are here. Along with your standard multiplayer modes, there are three single-player modes. You can choose Ultra to see how quickly you can clear 150 lines, Sprint to see how many you can clear in 3 minutes, and then there's my favorite, which is Marathon, and this lets you play to the bitter, bitter end. The premise of the new Tetris is simple. For every several thousand lines you clear, one of the seven wonders of the world will be built. I've always loved this about the title. It really gives you the sense that every line you clear is working towards something. Once you set the line collection goal for a given wonder, you're treated to a little cutscene that gives you a closer look at what you just built. Now this is more novelty than anything, but with upwards of 470,000 lines to clear just to unlock the Russian wonder, at least we get something. The game plays extremely well, the controls are fast and fluid. You can see a few pieces ahead, and you have that hold area as well, which allows you to keep one Tetrimo aside for just the right moment. And the best thing of all is that once your Tetrimo hits the ground, it's there for good, so there's none of that infinite piece-spinning garbage that goes on in more modern versions of the series. One of my favorite things about this game is the ability to create multi and mono squares. These are essentially squares that form when you combine four Tetrimos in a 4x4 arrangement. The big payoff is that whenever you clear a line that consists of a mono or multi-square, each line is credited as 5 and 10 lines respectively. It also makes a really cool sound when you clear it, much like the way your stomach sounds after scarfing down a chalupa. The multi and mono squares really up the ante of the risk-reward factor in the series. I always find myself teetering on the brink of, should I go for the square and hope I get all the right pieces, or should I just keep the lines clean? But hey, when you're trying to collect 20,000 lines to build your wonder, it pays to clear as many of those squares as possible. Graphics are pretty clean on the play screens and pretty muddy when it comes time to waltz through that wonder you worked so hard to unlock. But what do you want? This is the N64 we're talking about here. Where the audio is concerned, the music strives for a real world beat vibe, which appropriately matches the different locales featured in the game. Stat tracking is an extra little bonus here. The game keeps track of every line you've ever cleared, and a cool little chart tells you how many lines you cleared in some of your best games. All in all, if you can manage to get your hands on a copy of the new Tetris, keep it.
Well, I hope you enjoyed that, and like I said, the new Tetris has always been one of my favorite versions of the game. If you want to pick up a copy yourself, it can be kind of difficult. They're not easily found in the used bin at the video game store, but you can probably pick one up on eBay for around $30.